Many Floridians are calling the cops on these manatees because they seem like they might need help. And they are posting videos online and they are calling the cops to say, hey, can you help them? But turns out they don't need help at all. Here's a little clip of them going at it. They seem very close to the shore.
They seem very close to each other.
Exactly, and this is actually posted by the Pinellas County Sheriff's Office, which said, if you see this, don't call us. This is mating season. Apparently, it's the sea cow time to get it on. They said, if you see this, no you didn't. We get calls all the time from citizens when they see this, believing the manatees are in distress. We can assure you, they're more than fine. There's no need to call us. Which is very, very funny. And yes, according to the Save the Manatee Conservation Charity, manatees have group sex. They don't form pair bonds like other animal species do. Instead, a single female is followed by a group of a dozen or more males in a mating herd. The female manatee then mates with one or more males in a sort of free-for-all mating process that can last 3 weeks, the group said. You're gonna need a lot of water. however, it's a little distressing because the mating process can also be quite violent, with animals twisting and turning with vigor, according to Swimming with Manatees, I guess this organization. Despite appearances, humans should not intervene. Florida state law mandates that it is illegal to annoy, molest, harass, or disturb any manatee. And if there are any children around, that is effectively CRT, and so they can destroy the manatees. No, I don't know what happens if there are children around. I don't know what goes on. But there's more, you guys. I just think it's interesting. I don't know if you saw that there have been groups of small blue whales that actually have gathered similarly and actually beached themselves on the shore because it seems like they were sick and they died. So it's not strange to me that people would see a bunch of sea creatures and be like, oh my God, sea creatures are dying, we understand this, and or rising up, I should call and alert the authorities.
So what I'm getting out of this is, if these manatees are a rockin', don't come a knockin'. So to be fair to people, they're not calling because they're upset about the gangbang, okay? They're really worried about, they don't know that they're having sex. They think that they're hurt and then they might be in trouble. But I love the sex part of the story because it's probably a head trip for a lot of folks. I mean, I'm an atheist and I believe in science, so this is not at all surprising to me. But a lot of people do projection and they think like, oh, 12 on one, that sounds so dirty. No, it's dirty for us, it's not dirty for them. That's their DNA. And so yes, a lot of animals don't do what we do and we don't do what they do, but a praying mantis that bites the head off of the male lover after they're done isn't immoral. It's just the praying mantis.
That's she's a goddamn queen.
Well, she is in her world. I wouldn't particularly like it, but good thing I'm not a praying mantis. Jordan,
have you ever seen sea mammals do it?
Not lately. When we got the list of stories for tonight, I skimmed that headline and took a while to read it. And my first thought was people were just sincerely calling the cops. I mean, you pointed out it was out of concern, but I was thinking like, what if it was like a Karen type of person who their first instinct was to just call the police? And I've spent like half the day thinking about that and getting a lot of enjoyment out of it. So if people are, you know, just ho-hum about this story, please just imagine some angry Karen, that iconic image of the woman with the glasses scowling, just calling the police because they're having sex in public and it's indecent. But to your point, I think this is something that could easily get tripped up with the DeSantis regime. This is something that they could easily come after, trying to limit, trying to ban. It's something kids should not see. It's offensive and yes, it has no place in Florida.
Well, especially there's more details because it's interesting. The manatees are some of the cutest sea mammals, but like have some of the freakiest sex. And apparently, they can have such like violent sex they can become a danger to themselves. I'm gonna try and get through this. Officials revealed last week that a captive 38-year-old manatee, they're old, they live for a long time, named Hugh, died after having too much high intensity sex with his brother, Buffett. This was in an aquarium, the Moat Marine Laboratory and Aquarium. Said on the day of Hugh's passing, Hugh and Buffett, once again brothers, engaged in natural yet increased mating behavior observed and documented in manatees in both managed care and in the wild. This was the first time such heightened mating behavior was witnessed between the two manatees, meaning they really got it on this time. Again, both male manatees doing it because queerness exists everywhere. This was fun. A necropsy, I don't know how to pronounce this, performed by the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission's Marine Mammal Pathobiology Lab found the fatal wound was 14.5 centimeters long tear in the ventral wall of his colon.
Wow. So
I don't even want to, you guys know what happened.
No, there was, as you said earlier in the story, quoting the outlet here, they were twisting and turning with vigor. It's a lot of vigor in the colon there to cause that kind of damage. Okay, so, but I need people to understand this. And this actually, there's a serious point here. Like, folks have this idea, this is shared by a lot of people in the world, that God has created us in a certain way, right? And but, and we were talking about this in the earlier story of the Republican legislator in Tennessee, and how he's worried about, oh my God, if I'm in a room with someone and with a woman, I'm gonna go crazy, etc. And God doesn't want that. But why did God create you that way if he doesn't want you to be that way? And why did he create manatees in this way? Are there really things that are moral and immoral that are in nature, when all the different animals act in some similar ways and different ways? So to Francesca's point, gay relationships exist in tons and tons of different animals, including human beings. So did God make a mistake? Did he make a mistake with us? Did he make a mistake with the manatees? Isn't it kind of insulting to God to say, hey, you created people this way, but big guy, I think you screwed up. Really? Really, you're gonna tell God that? Or is God a prankster and he's like, oh, I'll make some of the humans and the penguins and the manatee gay, but then tell them they can't do it and then punish them in manatee hell?
That one, that part. I feel like legitimately some like crazy right winger like Christians think that part.
Yeah, and then I was thinking, guys, for manatees, what is quote unquote normal, the more standard form of sex is 12 on one or more, right? 12 guys on one woman. So do they think that the monogamous manatee are immoral? Because it's less natural to manatees. So I don't know, think about it.
You know, at a time where you have orcas attacking boats, now I'm wondering like what went through their mind, what changed that made them suddenly do something that we really don't have any documented history of. You know, outside of a few outliers, likely as a result of zoocosis and in the cases of SeaWorld, they really don't attack people, but now they're going after boats. I'm wondering like if there was any conversations among species, hey, do you wanna join us in this quest? The manatees were just like, nah, it's gangbang season, we're busy.
Just
go on without us, have fun.
That's
now
what they're doing. They're abdicating their responsibility. Like, come on guys, let's join the revolution. They're like, nah, we're doing orgies, like love.
Well, you know,
that's exactly right.
I got one last question about that. So why did God make it natural for manatees to be 12 on one and us one on one? Is he just like, hey, like, oh, it's Saturday. Oh, I got an idea. For these folks, let's make it 12 on one, and that's the moral and natural thing to do. And for these folks, only one on one and only with the same sex, because that's the moral and natural thing to do. Why? Like, could it really be that it's part of nature, that there's a morality that is part of nature itself or God's intent, if it doesn't apply to all living creatures? I just want you to think that through.
No, I think, you know what, we've been all like, honestly, like no DeSantis here, but I think we've all been poisoned pilled by Disney and the idea that like like all animals are actually just humans inside of like, you know, costumes, like in the Chinese zoo. You know, and they were all like, we mate for life, and they feel sad and they feel shame and they feel all of these things. And it's like, look, this is no disrespect to, I'm sure, some rabid vegetarians and vegans who are gonna get mad at me about all the animals that have feelings. That's not what I'm saying. You know, I am talking about like, yeah, that's how they mate, and they don't really ascribe a like, this is kinky, or like, this is dirty, or this is holy. Like, there's nothing ascribed to it. Just the same as when we see that, we shouldn't, because I know there's also like other people who are like, well, you know, like rape in the animal kingdom, that happens all the time. Like, yeah, but you have the power of reason and empathy. That's why you don't go around hurting and raping people, right? Animals don't got that. Like, that's what separates us here. So it's funny how it goes both ways. And I feel like there is some bizarre, like, rather than like appreciating like how humans are unique, we're instead like, no, we're just like animals. It's all the same, you know? So I don't know, it goes.
Yeah.
People are weird when it comes to humans versus animals.
So Franny, you're forcing me to make two more points about that.
Okay, because let's keep going.
Yeah, because look, if you think about it, they have different DNA. Which animals? Humans are like animals. Which animal? Penguins or lions? Because penguins and lions are so different. Which one are we like? What do you mean, right? So for lions, since they have different DNA, sometimes what they'll do is if they want to mate with a new lion, they will find her children and murder them and then eat them. And then the female lion's like, oh, okay, I guess that's what happened. And then they mate. We would find that to be the most monstrous thing in the world. Why? Because it's not in our DNA, but it is in their DNA. They're not immoral for doing that, and we are not the same. And to Franny's point, no, animals could certainly have feelings depending on the animal, and it depends on what you mean by feelings exactly, but they don't have human feelings. They have the feelings of that particular animal. Stop projecting our DNA onto them.
Yes. Animals are innocent.
There you go. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.